हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स एंड गॉस थ्योरम लेक्चर सेकंड आई विल डिस्कस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू अ यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड वायर ऑफ इनफाइनाइट लेंथ। लेट अस कंसीडर अ वायर ऑफ इनफाइनाइट लेंथ एंड वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड due to this uniformly charged wire at a point P at distance small r from this wire. For this, we will consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface of length small l around this wire. Here, I am showing you, this is wire and this is Gaussian surface of length small l. This is cylindrical in shape. Now the wire is uniformly charged. The linear density of charge on this wire is lambda. So the charge enclosed inside this cylinder will be q is equal to lambda into small l, because the length of this cylindrical Gaussian surface is small l. To determine the electric field, we determine the electric flux passing out through this Gaussian surface in two ways. First by definition and second by Gauss theorem, and then we compare both this electric flux. So to determine the electric flux passing through this Gaussian surface, by definition we will use this relation, phi is equal to cyclic integral s e dot ds. Now this integral is over the complete Gaussian surface, so we can't determine the value of this integral in one attempt. So we will divide this Gaussian surface into three parts. One is this part, this part, this we call s1, and second is this upper part, this is S2, and third is this lower part, this is S3. We will obtain the electric flux separately passing all the three surfaces, and we sum to obtain the total electric flux passing through this Gaussian surface. So phi is equal to integral S1 E dot ds plus S2 E dot ds plus S3 E dot ds. Now to evaluate this integral, we must know the angle between the electric field and element area. We will consider element area ds here, also a small element area ds on this S2, and a element area ds on this surface S3. This is point P. So the direction of electric field at this point is perpendicularly outwards, and also the area vector will be outwards like this. So the angle between E and ds at S1 will be 0. So we will get here E ds cos 0. Similarly at S2, this is S2. Over here the electric field will be along this line, and the element area means area vector will be along this line. So the angle between them will be 90 degree here. Similarly here also angle between E and ds will be 90 degree. So we will solve this integral. You will get the value of this integration 0. This integration will also be 0, and this integral will become integral S1 E dot ds. Now we have to evaluate this integral. We will first look upon this electric field. Electric field is constant throughout the surface S1, because the distance from the wire of all the points of the surface S1 is same. So electric field will be constant over all this surface S1. We can take capital E out of this integral. We will write like this. Now we have integral S1 ds. We have to evaluate this integral. To obtain the value of this integral, what will we do? So first let us explain what does this integral means. Ds is a small area element on the surface S1, and if we integrate this element area on the total surface S1, then it will provide the area of this total surface S1. Now what is the area of this total surface S1? Length is L and the distance from this wire is R. So what is the area of this surface S1? Now to evaluate this area, I am cutting this Gaussian surface into separate parts. Like here, cutting it over here. This is S2, this is S3, this is wire, this is the surface area S1. You have to find out the area of S1. This is length, small l, and the radius is r. So this circumference will be 2 pi r, and this length is l. Now we will open it like this. This is area of S1. So this length is 2 pi r, this is L. So 2 pi r into L will provide you area of this part of Gaussian surface which is S1. So we can write this integral into 2 pi r into L. Now we have obtained the electric flux passing through this Gaussian surface with the help of definition. Now we will determine the same thing by the help of Gauss theorem. From Gauss theorem we know that phi is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 k into q, where q is the charge which is enclosed inside the Gaussian surface, and I have evaluated the value of this charge from this equation 1. Q is equal to lambda into L. We will substitute this value here at in the place of q. This will become 1 upon epsilon 0 k into lambda L. So this is flux, phi is equal to lambda L upon epsilon 0 k. We have obtained flux by Gauss theorem. Now both the flux will be same. So comparing equation 4 and 5, we will get E into 2 pi r L is equal to lambda L by epsilon 0 k. We will obtain value of electric field at point E as capital E is equal to 1 upon 2 pi epsilon 0 k lambda by r. We will multiply this equation by 2 and also divide by 2. So this will become E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 k 2 lambda by r. We can assume a unit vector n along the area vector ds at point P. This unit vector is n cap. So we can write this electric field in vector form as E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 k 2 lambda by r into unit vector n. You can notice from this equation that electric field varies with distance. Now we plot a graph between electric field and distance, we will obtain a curve which is hyperbola. Next we determine the intensity of electric field due to an infinite charged conducting plate. The charge given to any conducting plate is distributed on its surface. There is no charge inside the surface of the plate. So electric field inside the plate will be zero. We have to determine intensity of electric field at point P at a distance small r perpendicular from the plate. Let us consider the surface density of charge on the conducting plate is sigma. To determine the intensity of electric field at point P, we will first consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface as shown here in this figure, and the area of cross section of this Gaussian surface is capital A. Let us consider again a Gaussian surface like this, and this Gaussian surface is kept like this. The area of cross section means this area of cross section of this Gaussian surface is capital A. Now we will consider the surface density of charge on this conducting plate to be sigma. then the charge enclosed inside this Gaussian surface will be Q is equal to sigma into A. Now here also we will determine the electric flux by two ways, first by definition and second by applying Gauss theorem, and then we compare both these flux. So according to definition of electric flux, phi is equal to integral S E dot ds. We cannot solve this integral as such, so we divide this integral into three parts. One over this Gaussian surface, which is S3 here. One over this Gaussian surface, which is S1 here. And one over this Gaussian surface, which is S2 here. And we evaluate these integrals separately, and then we add them to find the electric flux passing through this Gaussian surface. So on this surface S1, the direction of area vector ds and electric field will be in same line. So here E dot ds cos 0, theta is 0 here. Inside this conducting plate, electric field is 0. So value of this integral will become 0 because E electric field is 0. And on surface S3, area vector of element ds is in this direction and electric field is in this direction. So angle between E and ds is here 90 degree. So here E ds cos 90. Cos 90 will be 0, so this integral will also become 0. Now we have got E ds cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, so this will become integral over S1 E ds. Now the electric field on this area S1. This area is S1. This is Gaussian surface. This area is S1. All the points of S1 are at equal distance, small r, from this plane. So the electric field on this surface S1 will be constant. So capital E can be taken out of this integration, and we get E integration S1 ds. Now we have to find out the value of this integration. Ds is small element area on this surface S1. If we integrate this element area on this complete surface S1, we will get the total area of this surface S1, means total area of this surface S1, which is equal to the area of cross section of the Gaussian surface and is given by capital A. So in place of this integral, we can write capital A. It will become E into A. Now we will evaluate the electric flux again by Gauss theorem. Phi is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 K into Q. Here Q is the charge enclosed inside the Gaussian surface, which I have obtained from equation 1 as Q is equal to sigma into A. So we substitute the value of Q from equation 1 here. It will become 1 upon epsilon 0 K sigma into capital A. From this equation number 3 and this equation number 2, we will equate to obtain electric field at point P. So compare these equation 2 and 3 because both are electric flux and both will be same. So E into A is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 K sigma into A. If we assume a unit vector along the direction of electric field capital E on surface S1, then this electric field can be written in vector form as vector E is equal to sigma by epsilon 0 K into unit vector N. Next topic is electric field due to a uniformly charged infinite dielectric plane plate. If the charge is distributed on one plane side of a dielectric plate or a sheet of paper, because paper is dielectric, dielectric means insulating or non-conducting, then the distribution is known as plane sheet of charge. Here I have shown you a plain sheet of paper. Charge is distributed on one side. This sheet is having infinite extension, and we have to determine the intensity of electric field near to the sheet at a distance small r at point P. Let us consider point P on one side and P dash on other side of the sheet at equal distances from the sheet, and this distance is small r. Electric field at this point P and P dash will be same in magnitude but will be opposite in direction. Now to determine the electric field at these points, we will consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface. This cylindrical Gaussian surface is considered across the sheet like this, and this Gaussian surface is such that its ends are parallel to the sheet and pass from point P and P dash. The area of cross section means this area of cross section of this Gaussian surface is capital A. I have shown it here. Then the charge enclosed inside this Gaussian surface will be Q is equal to sigma into A, where sigma is the surface charge density. Now we will determine the electric flux by two ways, one by definition and one by Gauss theorem. So first we will determine the electric flux passing through this Gaussian surface by the help of definition, that is phi is equal to integral E dot ds. Here again we will divide this integral into three parts, one on this surface S1, another on this surface S2, and third on this surface S3 here. So phi is equal to S1 E ds cos 0, because on S1 angle between E and ds is 0. Similarly on S2 angle between E and ds is also 0. So we will get E ds cos 0 at S2 and E ds cos 90 on S3. Here on S3 the area vector will be in this direction and electric field due to this sheet will be in this direction. So the angle between them will be 90 degree. This integration will become 0 because this is cos 90 degree. Now we will get phi is equal to integral S1 E ds plus integral S2 E ds. The electric field on these surfaces, this is S1 and this is S2. So the electric field on these surfaces will be constant everywhere. So E will be taken out of these integration. Here, E integral S1 ds plus E integration S2 ds. But we have to find out the value of these integrals on surfaces S1 and S2. So let us consider here element area ds on this surface S1. If we integrate this ds on this complete area S1, then it will provide the area of this part S1. So we can write integral S1 ds is equal to capital A, because area of cross section is capital A. Similarly we can show for this surface S2 that ds integral S2 is also equal to capital A. We will substitute the value of these integrals here in this equation. Phi is equal to E into A plus E into A, it will become 2EA. Again we will obtain the flux passing through this Gaussian surface with the help of Gauss theorem. Now phi is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 k into q, where q is the charge enclosed inside this Gaussian surface, and the value of this charge is equal to sigma into A. We will substitute this value here to get 1 upon epsilon 0 k sigma into A. Both the flux will be equal. So from equation 2 and 3 we can write 2EA is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 k sigma into A. We will obtain the value of E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon 0 k. Direction of this electric field at point P and P dash will be perpendicularly outwards from the sheet. if the sheet is positively charged. And if this sheet is negatively charged, then the direction of electric field will be inwards.